Welcome to Tier 53 Faction War. This is Angel Gate and Orks versus Space Marines for the Blue Orky team. We've got Fogos as a Kommando Nob, infiltrating commander that shoots you, stabs you, and blows you up. Orky style begins range combat with a twin link shooter alongside Bashful. Pwny is a Warboss, a melee commander that can walk through objects, some good offense, disruption, and support from the front lines, and perpetual anger. Rounding off the Blue Orky team, then Deuce is a Mekboy, teleporting commander that fights range combat, puts out some good damage, can also support, disrupt, build structures, and repair. For the Red Space Marine team, we've got two Force commanders. First up is CUCK, DESPOILER. Yes, that's the name he's chosen to go with. And alongside Scuzzy, these guys fight in melee combat with some very strong offense, can also tank, disrupt, and support with buffs. This is the Space Wolves Elite scheme, which is pretty damn cool, I think. This guy's got a cool face, and DESPOILER with Blood Ravens. Rounding off the Red Space Marine team, Kim Dank possible as a Techmarine, starts off range combat, puts out some good damage, can also support with structures and repair. Wade into melee combat too. He is charged with looking after the southwest of the map, which has these two contested power points, can be very important to get them and hold them throughout Tier 1, Tier 2. Can really set you up for a strong Tier 3, and of course, Space Marines love their strong Tier 3s. Might see a turret down here. We'll see how it goes. And we've seen how crazy massed knob squads can be in these faction wars, but the Space Marines have two Force commands, which means two Assault Terminators possibly, which means Lightning Claws, which wreck knobs. So be interesting to see if the Orks forego knobs and go for Flash Kits with Blasters masked up, shooting the crap out of Marines instead. They will need something to deal with vehicles though, and possible Land Raiders, which knobs are really good at, with Warboss support especially. They are bashing power early on here, getting a node down. 15 red fear. These Orky sluggers are going for the power, I think. With some burners up. Yes, they are. Gives them a couple of power melee weapons and burners, which are great for taking out structures. These scouts being chased off here. And are those other sluggers still in their retreat path? They might be on, and they've gone a bit too far, I think. There's nothing there to meet them, so they might get all of those gens and that power point. That's going to be a rough start for the Space Marines, though. They do have both of these contested powers. One of them is even being noded early on. I think it's important, if you get those powers early on, you better node them. Or why are you taking them? Because they're just going to get taken back, because you can't sit there forever. You're going to be pushed off at some point. If you leave them unnoded, they're going to be decapped at least. This Shooter Boy squad getting away with just one model. 36 hit points. Force Commander is charging around, chainsawing stuff to death. Oh, he did a battle cry, so he's missing now with special attacks. Sluggers moving in. They can be pretty scary, even in Tier 1, with those burners. If they catch you unawares or catch you in retreat, power melee weapons are painful. Oh, look at that. There's that burn that house thing. Slowed down the game there for a second. So many particle effects going off. This game doesn't handle lots of particle effects very well. Sluggers backing off now. Dropped only one model. They can stay in play. Four shooter squads with the Kommando Nob there. They've still packing a punch, that little Orky army. Force commander's coming out from DESPOILER, but is under half hit points. Tactical Marines on capping duty. Good early start from Orks. You expect them to be aggressive early on. What's this? Oh no. Mekboy's gone down. Didn't teleport quickly enough, did ya? Here comes Kim Dank possible. He's got Devastators set up to cover this approach. And as you can see, he's taking the action away from this contested power. He's noded both of them, nicely done. And now he's making the Orks approach him and engaging away from those power points. But he's been forced off completely here, mobbed by at least two players. Stormboy's on the field for Deuce. Power melee weapons, jump squad can be incredibly dangerous, especially Tier 2, when they start leveling up and get their incredibly scary knob leader. Vengeance rounds for these Devastators, their advanced targeting. 75% more damage to all units, including vehicles, of course. 900% more damage to vehicles, bloody hell. But they don't suppress. They're gonna die as well. I just talked you up, fellas, and you die immediately. Shotgun blast. Almost got the Warboss down, but it retreats just in time. Should be able to rebuff the Orks here. But did drop that Devastator squad, and that was... was that DESPOILER or Scuzzy? DESPOILER's Devastator's there. He does have another squad though. Coming out right now. There we go. Triple shooters for Fogos. Lots and lots of piercing damage. Scouts especially are going to be under a lot of pain, but screw scouts, even heavily armored tactical marines getting shot to pieces there by all of those shooter boys with big shooters as well. Look at that DPS, and that's with the aiming what's that suppressing them, which doesn't do a lot of damage, but that suppression is nasty on demand. Scout trying to shotgun some power, but that's not going to work out very well for him. Sluggers in retreat path, lots of shooty action going on, and down they go. You cannot have too much DACA. Bad retreat path, says DESPOILER. Pretty standard retreat path, I think. Where do you expect him to go? Around there? Not going to happen. Should have moved them off and then retreated. Death gun up for the Mekboy. Doing a sizable amount of damage. Those assault marines at close range there, but the scouts get in, trying to force him into melee combat, but he teleports away, facing the wrong way. But can now turn around and engage. Here we see the Warboss getting increasingly angry. Hasn't had a good time of it so far. Gets forced off relatively quickly, it seems. He's got that boss pole up, though. And we're going to see another Devastator squad go down from DESPOILER, I think. Yes, we do. Good usage of the shooter boys then got into melee combat and finished them off in range. And DESPOILER's down to just a single unit. Some tactical marines is all he has. 455 to 445. Very close on VPs, 2-1 cap for the Orks right now. Tier 2 though for the Space Marines. Keeping these bottom powers really helps them get through Tier 1. Stormboys jumping in. This could be really painful for those Devastators, but Assault Marines jumping in to save them with some disruption. Now they're going for the Garrison and they should be safe. In fact, they didn't even need to go for the Garrison. Orks forced off completely down here. And Stormboys live, but Deuce didn't. He dropped one of his Shooter Boys, did he? Here we see some sluggers with burners going for the power again. It's full, nice and juicy. What do we have defending? Nothing yet. Kommando Nob trying to cap, but he is forced to retreat. Level 2, no war gear. Where's that war boss at? Going to see him smack some Space Marines' heads in. He should have a sync kill where he picks up two of them and cracks their heads together. Is that a whirlwind? It is a whirlwind, which could be good against these very, very blobby Orks. Hard not to blob up, really, on Angel Gate. Don't have a lot of room to maneuver, really, especially on these side areas. Decent amount of space on this central road here. Force Commander with the Thunderhammer. Expect the Thunderhammer from both Force Commanders, really. DESPOILER with some more tactical marines. He's got no war gear, needs to defend his power over here. Going to be wiped out, I think. Just a node remaining. He might be able to tie them up and battle cry them around. Meanwhile, Deuce isn't having a great time. Sluggers do escape, but the Mekboy went down and he lost his other shooter boys. Yep, Deuce not liking fighting the 1-1-1 of Kim Dank Possible. Using it quite well so far with the shotgun scouts, of course. Adds a lot to this 1-1-1 build, shotgun scouts. The extra measure of control and disruption really, really helps. Something's on your devs and your assault marines are elsewhere, shotgun blast. Something's on your hero, you don't want him in melee combat, shotgun blast. Nob leader queued up for the Storm Boys. It's like 400 hit points all by himself or something, and some heavy melee as well. Deuce goes tier 2. So a player from both sides dropping a lot in tier 1, the end of tier 1. The Storm Boys are going to wipe though, yes they are. Jumped into a Thunderhammer Force Commander, which was not very smart. Kind of orky. Got a truck, says Bashful Pwny, and here it is. Transport vehicle for Orks, as is a reinforce and transport allied infantry. Does really well for Orks, you can pile some sluggers in there and cause havoc. Here's another truck being shot by the Hunter Killer missile of the Whirlwind. Not much else around in terms of hard AV, but there's a lot of stuff shooting it. Oh, we've got a power fist from DESPOILER, and that is a strange one. You lose most of your army, you're in tier 2, and you spend 200 rec, 50 power on a power fist against Orks in tier 2. Not what I would have expected at all. We'll see how it fares. There's that Mekboy Global that I always forget the name of. Cult of Speed, I think it's called. Speeds up your vehicles and lets them shoot faster, which is always nice. Here's a weird boy for Fogos, which could be incredibly powerful. Oh, Power Fist Force Commander doing some work here. Helps take out one truck. Could completely take out another one all by himself. And yes, he does. Has the fist paid for itself? It might have. He's got an artificer armor and teleport pack and is now switching to the chainsword and storm shield. Very strange. Bashful, Pwny and Deuce now looking a little bit thin with 3 units and 2 units respectively. Space Marines continue to hold the Southwest powers. And now they're starting to go across the map and take stuff as they go. That's a lot of damage though on these tactical marines. Was that the foot of Gork? No, it wasn't. It must have been just one of his basic attacks followed up by shooter fire, and down goes that squad. This guy's not paying attention, Mr. Skazi. There we go. Need to run away, fella. He's got a tactical marine sergeant there. Doesn't want to lose that squad for sure. What's this? Sluggers continuing to be sneaky. These are Bashful ponies. But having to contend with whirlwind disruption while trying to take out this power generator. Should be able to do it though, I think. Uh-oh. First one teleports in with a power fist. Takes out a model immediately. Boom. Takes out another one. Power fist, I think, has paid for itself. Level 3 Force Commander. He sacrificed field presence for that very, very scary Force Commander right there. Slugger's running away, but they do get away. Uh-oh, Assault Marine's on the Mekboy. I don't think he can teleport our way. He can teleport away. There we go. Didn't think he had enough energy there, but I guess he did. Oh, double stick bombers for Deuce. Not sure how that will work out with the Assault Marines around, but does have Sluggers there to meet them if they jump in. Do they have their sergeant? They do not, so no Merciless Strike to worry about quite yet. What is this? What is this truck doing? Getting very close. Oh, he's got his special shoot to the Kommando Nob. Awesome Orky shotgun that does a massive amount of damage with that high explosive shells ability that you just saw there. Took those Devastators down to half health, pretty much. And they're pressuring the power again. Starting to really come back into this, the Orks. Skazi and Despoiler pretty low on their rosters here. But Despoiler goes tier 3. Uh-oh. But might lose Tactical Marines in retreat. They just wandered into trouble there. Not paying attention, he does lose them. 287, 352, 1-to-1 cap. Space Marines with a VP lead, and they're going to need it because Despoiler is going tier 3 with one unit. Skazi has recovered slightly with Devastator Plasma Cannon and Tactical Marines dropping in. Some Space Wolves, Grey Hunters, I guess, or something, joining the fight. But so much DACA. Just all of the DACA they have here. They're using the drop pod as heavy cover now. They can also reinforce off this thing, I believe. Lost the indicator for the Force Commander. What else has this guy got? He's got good old Artificer. Uh-oh. Tank Buster Barrage. So dangerous. I can one-shot a lot of vehicles, that thing. Whirlwind survives, though. And that War Truck survives with a little bit of help from the Cult of Speed. Terminators, though, are on the field for Kim Dank Possible. Wondered if he was going to wait for the Venerable Dreadnought to see if Nob Squads hit the field. And he can counter with the Venerable Dreadnought. But he's gone for Terminators. Start with Power Fists and Storm Bolters. Both doing a hell of a lot of damage. Level 4 Force Commander for the Spoilers. Got the Teleporter Pack. No sign of the Sacred Standard yet. Thought we'd see it for sure. Can do a massive amount of work on Angel Gate when there's these big team fights. Very cramped. Everyone's in the same place. Buff everyone with the Sacred Standard. Bashful's got the idea with his boss pole. Also got the Power Claw now. 95 DPS. Heavy melee. One of the most powerful hero weapons in the game. In terms of raw DPS. Stick bombs being annoying. Stunning and then bombing. And what was that? Oh, you fellas are turning into Stern Guard. I see. Oh, rocks. That might wipe one of those marines if it gets knocked back into the other rocks there. Smack. Big hit. Can they finish off that last model? They can. That was a good plasma cannon shot though. Orks really pushing hard here. I don't think they need to push this much. They could have gone back to the VP. Let the space marines come onto them. But they've gone in for the kill. Use your choppers on these sluggers. Might need to buff them again with Ard Boys. That was a good merciless. That's against Vanguard veterans as well, not just Assault Marines. That is Ard Boys on them, but that is a dicey fight for them to stay in. Lucky, perhaps. Lucky there, I think. They got that special attack from the Nob Leader just before they retreated, which meant that they couldn't get hits in. I think that saved them. Really did save them. Warboss has gone down. So no boss pole buffs going off. He's got a lot of red though, and he's in tier 3. He can almost nuke himself. Meanwhile, steel double stick bombers for Deuce, and he's going for after this VP. But he's met a Power Fist, a Thunderhammer even. Just Scuzzy, he's got a teleporter pack as well. So it doesn't look like we're going to see the Sacred Standard. I'm not sure if the spoiler cancelled that storm shield or not. Oh, look at this. Deuce has taken the bottom powers, I think, for the first time in the game. The spoiler now going for a Dreadnought, maybe expects Nob Squad to hit the field. Here's some Flashkits, though, with their blasters. And they have their Git Finders too, you can tell because of that plus icon on the indicator there. Boom. They do Air of Effect psychic damage. Don't ask me how blasters do psychic damage. They're Orks, they can do what they want. And it does a lot of damage to heavy infantry and super heavy infantry, so dangerous to pretty much everything on the Space Marine roster apart from their vehicles. Cyclone Missile Launcher for Kim's Terminators here. Can disrupt a large bunch of Orks and finish off a vehicle and that kind of thing. Whoa, Techmarine got shot to pieces. You might want to think about getting his refractor field up. 275, 250. Tank Buster Barrage with some good disruption there. Looks like the Kommando Nob's going in to tie up those Devastators. Nicely done with some Orky headbutts. Some more Terminators here from Skazi, but he does not go for Assault Terminators. Very, very odd. Thought for sure we'd see the Assault Terminators from both of the Force Commander players if they had the opportunity. But no, he goes for the Range Terminator variety. And for those that don't know, only Force Commanders can get Assault Terminators. There's a Nob Squad though from Bashful Pwny and another one on the way for Deuce. And we know how scary they can be with Mekboy support, the super tough beam. Whirlwind's still around, it's done some work for Skazi. Level 2. Vanguard Veterans jumping in. Stick bombers don't want any part of that. A little bit of delay when they landed though for some reason. Sluggers are going to fight them though. Can they get a good Merciless? There's a Shotgun Blast. Allows the Vanguard Veterans to get some more hits in, and they are tearing apart those Sluggers with help from Devastators and Scouts there. Beamy Death Gun for the Mekboy. Does he want to hunt the Whirlwind with that? It's going to do some good damage to the Terminators too, since they are a large target Terminators. They take full accuracy hits from anti-vehicle weapons. And here's a Dreadnought. He's gone for Assault Cannon. So he did not get it in response to Nobs, unless he wants to disrupt them with the Assault Cannon Barrage instead of fighting them in melee, which I don't think is the way to go. But Assault Cannon will do some work for you for sure. Look at that. I mean, imagine a barrage hitting this blob of Orks. You see those yellow circles? That's because they're all buffed by the bus pole. Orange circles, even. That's a scary mob of Orks right here. Two Nob Squads in there. Sluggers, Stick Bombers, a whole bunch of shooters, not to mention the Warboss himself with the claw. Kim Dank Possible does not want to fight that. Terminators cannot retreat, but they can teleport away. There we go. Are they going to run into base? Nope. You have Scouts down here. No. Stone God Veterans down here capping. Can use their Hellfire rounds to do a lot of damage to Light Infantry Orks. Nob Squad, of course, are heavy infantry, so going to want to use Kraken rounds against those guys. Whirlwind is still around. That was a good plasma cannon shot on the Warboss and helps take him down there. No more boss pole buff. Tank Buster Barrage might finish off this Whirlwind for good. That's a Rocks. Does it get those? Oh, it one-shotted those Plasma Devastators, I think. Good advance from the York. Well, a very Orky advance from the Orks. Whirlwind lives somehow. Vanguard Veterans jumping in to a mob, including a Nob Squad. Very, very brave, lads. Weird Boy doing some friendly fire, but also knocking down and damaging the Vanguard Veterans. They might need to jump away soon. That was a big... Holy crap. Massive, massive bursts of damage from the Flashkits. And a Nob Squad getting a sink kill there. That was crazy. Marked target though on the Nob Squad. That's from the Techmarine Signum Armor. Oh, look at this. He's gone melee. He's gone for the Axe. Not very often you see the Axe with Signum. There he goes though. It does drain energy, I believe. I think... Yes. Drains 15 energy on hits. Don't think it gives it to the Tech Marine though. It's not like it returns it to the Tech Marine or anything. Assault Cannon, Terminator Squad. This Dreadnought's done okay so far. There's a barrage. That's pretty nasty. Flash Gits are also heavy infantry, so power melee and plasma damage doing a lot of damage to those guys. Force Commander's chasing them down for Skazi. Now he's going to eat a whole bunch of Daka. Uh-oh, Nob Squad going after the Dreadnought, but Whirlwind is there still. Level 3 to save the day with some disruption. Now Stone Guard Veterans fighting them, and these guys activating, and they shall know no fear, which gives them damage resistance, suppression, immunity maybe, and allows them to, I think it's a 50% chance to knock back on melee hits, which is why you saw that Nob Squad getting knocked all over the place there. It wasn't only the Whirlwind. They're still in play, these guys. They are suppressed, but they are not stopping. Down goes the Whirlwind. Lasted a hell of a long time. Skazi's Force Commander is also down. There's And They Shall Know No Fear again to fight these stick bombers. Dreadnought getting into melee as well. Inspiring on melee kill. That is a rocks. Big hit on those Stern Guard veterans. That's like the third one. Third nuke we've seen, and they've all done pretty well. Those Stone God veterans live though. Orks are piling forward. Terminator's being chased. They need some more. Devastator's on the field, I think. Oh, down goes that Dreadnought. They need something to suppress this massive blob of stuff. And that should have been a melee Dreadnought, I think. Oh, Terminator's wiped out. That is painful to see. Really painful to see. Surely those guys should have been Assault Terminators. Then again, Assault Terminators still get wrecked by Flash Gits from range. 146237. Land Raider Redeemer on the way for Skazi. That could be huge. And here's a melee Dreadnought from the spoiler. And he's got some Assault Terminators too. They are in their default Thunderhammer Storm Shield state, which isn't as effective as Lightning Claws at tearing apart Nob Squad. Nob Squad double buffed by Ardboys and User Choppers from the Warboss, but they are scared off by a hell of a lot of Space Marine stuff. Had full momentum from their hammers there, I think, as well. 146192. Space Marines need to take this half of the map back for sure. Constant pressure from the Orks. They really haven't let up. Haven't sat back on the contested VP. And they've done well out of it. But this might be a dead Mekboy. Yep, down he goes. Leveling up there, the Force Commander got a sync kill with his Power Fist. He is now level what? Let me see. 8. Bloody hell. Power Fist really has done well for him. But here we see those Flash Gits. Those instant hit Air of Effect blasters. That's scary. And they're being sped up by the Weird Boy as well with Warpath. Pazzo Cannon. Misses. VP's dead even, 2-1 for the Orks. Kim Dank Possible still fighting over the bottom. I think it's time to move on, fellas, and try and go after this victory point. Or triple up the top. Holy crap, those blasters are scary. Just deleted that plasma cannon with help from the Weird Boy there. Here comes the Force Commander. I thought he had the teleporter. He does have the teleporter. We don't see the indicator for it here. It's a bug. He should have the teleporter indicator, as you see on these Terminators here. Here's a Land Raider Redeemer. This could get the Space Marine straightened back into the game, and this is a big nuke. Big, big nuke here. I think that's from Skazi. Massive damage on those Flash Gits, but does not quite finish them off. Now they have infield reinforcement and a retreat point in the field as well. Is it enough? Holy crap. Not when Flash Gits are deleting your units. That's crazy. 146-122. We have a late game war truck from Bashful doing some work for the Orks up there. Reinforcing them and all that stuff. What's this? What's he up to? Oh, chasing some Terminators, but they can teleport back to base, it should be alright. Stone Guard veterans using their Kraken rounds, and it's the Techmarine with his refractor making him run away in the end. Suppression. And the Orks run off, or the Nob Squad runs off. Stick bombers. What are they doing? Oh, friendly bombs. I thought they were going to throw their stuns. I thought that was a waste. You got nothing to follow it up. Okay, Scout's going to get a decap here, I think, at least. Oh, maybe not. Here comes a whole bunch of Orks buffed by the war banners. Get away with a single model and live. They did not get the decap, though. Here comes the Nob Squad, suppressed by the Devastators, but it's going to get flanked really nastily here. Oh, knocked down by the knockback of the special shooter. Has a passive knockback. There we go. 30% chance. Land Raider is now at the top VP, but can they make it count? Looks like Bashful's backing away, waiting for his ally to come in and the rest of his units. Gonna try and stop the cap with some disruption from these explosions, and did so. Lightning Claw Terminators are in the field, and these guys eat Nob Squads for breakfast. If they're not buffed up crazily, anyway. Going after the Warboss himself here. While the Stoneguard Veterans cap. This is a big fight. And the Assault Terminators are getting absolutely wrecked by ranged fire and stuff. Force Commander takes down the War Truck, but now he's idle. Everything coming back to the Land Raider to get some reinforcement. Here's another Land Raider Redeemer from Kim and a nuke. It might miss the bulk of the forces, though. I think it does. Yes, it does. Gets a Nob Squad, but this Land Raider is taking a hell of a lot of damage. Just double Nob Squad on it. That's a lot of pain. And BB Duff again getting shots. The Land Raider goes down. The Land Raider goes down. And a rocks on the other one. Does not stop up here. 146 to 40. The Orks want this game. That's the Frag Assault. But double Frenzy popped on the Nobs. And they are going after it. And they are tearing it apart. Look at that damage. That's a Land Raider. Is it made of paper? Here we go now. These Nob Squads do not stop. Almost level 3, these fellas. That was just one touch on a Predator tank and it's down to half health. It's getting shots off. It's getting shots off and makes him retreat. There we go. It's a 2-to-1 cap for the Space Marines somehow. This guy teleports into retreat path. Bang. Tries to get some more models. The Lightning Claw Squad did live as well. And they're reinforced back to 3 models. Double cap for the Space Marines. But they are low. Low on their rosters. Yeah, they got both Land Raider Redeemers. That was big. Very, very big. Kommando Nob goes down. But he did get a decap there. You'd think the Orks are going to swarm across the map and just cap everything and finish the game off. But you never know. Space Marines are a resilient bunch. Here's the looted tank. Force Commander in retreat. Goes down to the Nobs and range fire. And good usage of the stick bombers there. Just making that stuff get the hell away. Can use them to control spaces. Warboss is level 6. He's got his heavy armor, so he's well above 2,000 hit points. Which is a hell of a lot for a hero, if you didn't know. Level 10 Force Commander here, up to 1,472 hit points. Gonna revive the Techmarine. Level 6 Force Commander for Scuzzy. 86 to 40 is very close on VPs. Orks looking pretty damn strong though. They're going to get the 2-to-1 hit. And this Force Commander needs to be very careful. His health is absolutely flying down. He's not going to get away, is he? No, he's not. It was not worth the revive there. What is this? Tactical Marines without a flamer. Coming to this and trying to bash, and they're going to get set upon by stick bombers. And the stick bombers are not bad in melee combat. Looks like it's kicking off on the contested VP. Looted tank going forward, trying to finish off the dreadnought there. There's the Emperor's Fist. Tank busters getting shots. Tank busters are a great little anti-vehicle unit, I think. The dreadnought lives somehow. Look at this though, double Nob Squad from Deuce. Gonna cut off the dreadnought if it doesn't go down to this squad, and it does. 2-to-1 for the Orks. They are gonna take this game for sure. The spoiler does have a Land Raider Redeemer on the field, though. Too little, too late. And that is scary flashkit blob from Fogos. He's got three of them. We saw them dismantle some tactical marine squads. And that's going to be the end of the game. Force Commander just saving those Terminators at the end. Yes, the Terminators lived. And there you have it. Warboss was just idle in the middle there, looking at his handiwork. Awesome stuff. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. And I'll see you next time.